tonight, we give thanks for the bonds we share with our loved ones.
I could have chosen any other grandparent, but I decided to choose her.
For those making the world a better place.
She noticed that there was a lack of opportunity for adults with intellectual developmental disabilities once they turn 21.
For those using their passion to follow their dreams.
Our world needs so much more love and kindness than what is out there, and I feel like this is our one step for what we can do to help make the world a better place.
For those who will forever remain young at heart.
Maggie's my idol. I want to be like her when I grow up.
For those who will do anything to put a smile on a child's face.
It took a good year and a half to make this dragon come into being.
And for miracles coming through when they're needed most.
I still can't believe it at this point. He shouldn't be alive right now.
Thanks so much for watching this Denver 7 Plus special presentation. Denver 7, positively Colorado. I'm Jason Grenauer. Over the course of the next little while, I'll be showing you some stories from the past year that bring to mind the thought or the feeling of giving thanks. We want to start with the Thornton family. Their father going through an arduous battle with COVID-19. The family facing nearly insurmountable odds, but never giving up. That family, thankful they'll be spending this holiday season all together.
It's a good thing this senior rehab center,
Martha, you need something?
Doesn't pay its employees by the step.
He definitely walks a lot. Yeah, he does.
Jaime Gonzalez walks laps around this place.
I help to the staff here and the residents too.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Making sure everyone is taken care of.
Yeah, let me know you need something, okay?
But this spring, it was Jaime that needed that care.
We try not to look at them. My little sister asked, how come dad is not awake?
The father of three had a severe case of COVID, needing to be intubated, requiring a machine to put oxygen into his blood. His son, Jesus, was given the news from doctors.
It was less than 1% chance of survival.
Weeks in, and Jaime's outlook wasn't improving.
Then when they told us that he wasn't gonna make it, my mom decided that she wanted to renew her vows before, you know, if anything happened before he passed away.
On his 25th anniversary, Jaime sent them a sign.
He says yes by squeezing his eyes and just closing them tight.
Weeks turned into months, and the longer he stayed in that hospital bed, the harder it was on Jaime's younger kids.
How do you tell a 9-year-old and a 7-year-old that their dad is gonna die, you know?
When doctors gave him just days to live, the family came together for a final goodbye.
Beso, besos.
We took a last picture as a family, as we thought it was gonna be our last picture as a family.
With few options left, Jesus asked doctors about a rare treatment, a high dose of steroids.
It's far away.
Gracias, pies.
Oh my God.
That's when he woke up.
It's a miracle.
On April 4th, Easter Sunday, and his youngest son's birthday, Jaime walked out of the hospital.
They never expected for that 1% to be walking out of the hospital.
He had spent 100 days in the ICU.
I still can't believe it at this point. He shouldn't be alive right now.
Alive, back on his feet, with a return in mind.
To work. You want to get back to work?
Hi, Maria. You need something?
With a little assistance.
This is my portable oxygen.
Jaime is back to walking his laps.
I saw the last time I was well for 2 miles.
And we have to tell him to slow down. It's like, slow down, we tell them, huh?
And helping out anyone who needs it.
I try to be happy all the time because I tell you, it's a great opportunity.
Jaime is back to work right now just as a volunteer. He's building up his strength, hoping to one day soon take back his full-time job as a certified nursing assistant. Well, from families to work families, you know, the pandemic shut down many businesses. This next story is about a group of people who are thankful they're back to work serving customers and not letting anything stop them.
The challenges of this pandemic.
I mean, it's tough.
Hit craft breweries like this one hard.
We were able to scrape through it.
closed for months under capacity restrictions, a staff mostly sent home.
Some of our employees didn't handle it as well or didn't quite understand why they weren't allowed to come to work.
Not because of a political disagreement about COVID, but because employees here already face their own set of daily challenges.
Napkins?
Yeah. Currently, we have 13 employees who have intellectual developmental disabilities.
This is Brewability.
Would you like any food?
Tanner Schneller and his wife Tiffany, a former special ed teacher, started this place.
She noticed that there was a lack of opportunity for adults with intellectual developmental disabilities once they turn 21.
So how do I charge them?
Here, employees brew and pour beer.
Okay, just one IPA for right now, Tiffany.
Just one IPA.
They wait tables. They work a real meaningful job.
She realizes how capable and how hardworking and how important it is for people to be able to seen as having potential.
Tony is one of Brewability's bartenders.
I just really like hearing the stories and the people, you know.
Though that isn't easy. Tony is both partially deaf and partially blind.
The really hard part is just figuring out where it's all coming from.
He calls this place a family.
What's up, guys?
Adding, if it wasn't for the brewery,
I don't think I would be doing anything. I think I would be unemployed and miserable.
So when the pandemic hit and the brewery shut down, that's what happened.
It's really hard because I need to get out of the house and I need to work for mental health reasons and you know physical health.
Stability is important, especially for people in this community.
But with case numbers now down and vaccines going out, that routine has started to come back. A rebound set to live jazz, fueled now by pizza.
Being able to add a kitchen during the second shutdown dealio. It's nice to have all of our staff back. It's nice to be welcoming customers through the door again.
It's just very calm and homely.
Brewability and Pizzability are now expanding their hours.
With more days, with more people in here, the more help we need. So. I know that we're going to start looking into hiring some people soon.
A business taking cues from its own employees.
This is for you.
Facing down challenges and coming out on top.
We're just excited to be busier, to bring more people into the fold, and have a fun, successful summer.
You can get a beer anywhere. You can get good bartending service anywhere. It's the customer service and it's that family community.
There are some very thankful people in our community thanks to the help of our Denver 7 Gives viewers. So let's recap some of the best of 2021, including the sled hockey team who had their trailer full of gear stolen. They provide an on-ice alternative for players with disabilities and wounded warriors. We told Colorado Sled Hockey's story and raised $10,000 to replace the equipment and the trailer.
Thank you, Denver 7, for helping us in this time of need, getting our guys and gals back out on the ice. And, you know, this is awesome.
And Papa Joe toys.
We also introduced you to Walker White, a 4-year-old boy with a rare heart condition. His family was struggling to keep up financially. Thanks to donations, Denver 7 donated $6,500 to the family to help pay their car payment and to buy new clothes for Walker.
What do you say? The amount of stress that takes off of us is like unbelievable.
Over the past year, we've learned how important it is to cherish family. For a young girl and her great-grandmother, they put that lesson into action.
Gosh, Rosie, I'm not going to remember all of this because I'm getting old.
Up next, how a school project helped make a bond even stronger. Thank you. Welcome back. You know, the holidays are a time for families to get together, to share stories, sometimes pass down advice from one generation to another. The woman in this next piece has enough stories to fill a book. Luckily for her, her great-granddaughter was willing to write it for her.
Yes, and she bless Connie's heart.
That sounds a whole lot like a video chat we've all had with a grandparent during this pandemic.
I want to watch you do some gymnastics, too.
But this bond goes well beyond this screen.
Do you remember the first time I reached out to you?
12-year-old Rozzy had to do a school project on one of her grandparents.
I could have chosen any other grandparent, but I decided to choose her.
Her great-grandmother, 91-year-old Dorothy Maneth.
When you called me, I thought, gosh, Rozzy, I'm not going to remember all of this because I'm getting old.
But she did remember trading letters with her great-granddaughter.
Once I got started, I remembered things.
A lot of things that gave Rozzy the idea to keep going.
The Dust Bowl, World War II.
And keep writing.
Her mom would get all, like, they'd save all the flower bags and they'd make dresses out of the flower bags.
To publish that story in a book.
Dorothy Maneth is an active, awesome, outgoing person, but my favorite part is that she is my great-grandmother.
It's called A Little Birdie Told Me.
And then the life of a woman as seen through the eyes of her great-granddaughter. I like that part.
A 77-page work available for sale on Amazon.
Left foot, right foot, left foot, right foot. Mmm, did Dorothy love dancing.
I like your drawing on them. That's another thing.
Oh, yeah.
On your cover.
She may be the subject of the book, but this great-grandma...
I thought that was really neat, too.
...is proud for a different reason.
I've got some friends that said, what a great gal she is. So anyway, you know you've made a hit.
Yeah.
A story told across generations.
I'm proud to say that my great-grandmother is named Dorothy Maneth and I love her.
That's brought these two closer than any video chat ever could.
You made my day and you made my life.
It truly is amazing what young people can do. And this next story is another example of that. A young man who didn't want to wait for a call back for a role. So he started his own theater company so he and other young people can break into the performance industry. And they're all thankful for the opportunity that it provides.
Passion is something that you really want to do in your life.
When you discover your passion in life, early.
I am 15 years old.
Why wait to put it into action?
You are here.
Austin Galinsky has been doing this for 2/3 of his young life.
I have been doing theater since I was 5 years old.
And he didn't want to wait to accomplish his goals.
It was my very own theater company.
My name is Regina George.
So he made his own.
Yeah, so 5280 Theater Company is made up of kids ages 7 plus.
30 members, cast and crew, all under 15.
By creating it, it not only gives me my passion in life, but it also gives others their passion.
That's why this performance outside the Denver Center for the Performing Arts isn't exactly impromptu. It's their latest show.
It's essentially a Broadway review. But all of our performers have been working hard for 3 months now.
That show, full of song, dance, and plenty of passion, is coming up at a dinner theater in Longmont.
Finish me off.
But the stage isn't the only thing Austin and his company feel strongly about.
Giving back to the community is my way of saying thank you.
Which is why a portion of the proceeds from this teenager's self-made show will be going to Children's Hospital.
Our world needs so much more love and kindness than what is out there, and I feel like this is our one step for what we can do to help make the world a better place.
Because nobody ever said that doing something you're passionate about had to be all about you.
If you follow your passion and your hopes and dreams, you will get there.
Let's get back to Denver 7 Gives for a moment. Some of the stories that made us thankful for our generous viewers. Stephen Garcia is a quadriplegic, and during a cross-country road trip, his family's camper was stolen. The camper was specifically outfitted for his needs. Denver 7 Gives raised $11,000 to replace that camper and help with the family's mortgage.
It just means to me that there are just so many good people out there. Thank you so much. I was really in tears.
And then there's the Welton Street Cafe, a staple of the Five Points neighborhood, dealing with thousands of dollars in bills, needing a new HVAC system, and more, fighting just to keep their doors open. Denver 7 Gives viewers donated more than $41,000 to do that and more.
What? Oh my gosh, really?
Yes.
Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh, that is crazy. I know, yay!
So far in 2021, Denver 7 Gives has raised and given out more than $440,000 in assistance to our community.
Coming up after the break, making the impossible possible through the hard work of the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
It took a good year and a half to make this dragon come into being.
Plus, you're never too old to play ball.
I, like a lot of the Peaches, just love the game and want to keep playing.
Welcome back. You know, the folks over at the Make-A-Wish Foundation and the people and companies that they partner with, they can do just about anything. So when a very special little girl came to them with a pretty unique and difficult to pull off wish, they pulled out all the stops to make it happen. And when they saw the smile on that young girl's face, they were thankful they did.
14-year-old Belle is battling bone cancer. So when it came time for her Make-A-Wish, she had to make it count.
She wanted almost the impossible, but not quite the impossible. She wanted a robotic dragon.
Not a toy, but a pet. Because of her cancer, she can't have a dog or a cat. So Aero Electronics and Victoria P. said,
it's not impossible. It's definitely doable.
They gathered the experts to try to make this one-of-a-kind wish come true.
We pulled in maybe 3 or 4 different companies to work together to provide the electronics, to have the expertise that we needed for building the software, the firmware, building the mechanical side of things, and building the physical casing and the skin for the dragon.
Electrical engineers, mechanical engineers, sculptors, and artists.
It took a good year and a half to make this dragon come into being.
And create this.
It does wag its tail, it moves its head, it gives you a wing display. Again, it does sit, it does lay down.
And interacts.
We designed the animations and pre-programmed it to react accordingly. It's very much alive in its own way.
Everything is one of a kind, from the 3D printed scales to the purple eyeballs. Impressive, even to the project manager.
Oh my gosh, I did not expect it to look this way, look this good.
But it would only be one opinion that mattered. On a snowy day in Sedalia, Belle met her dragon for the first time.
It's as close to a dragon could be as a robot.
Her reaction, just a little tamer because of how shy she is.
All the happies.
But a smile, making it all worth it.
I love it.
Our final story proves that age is just a number. The Colorado Peaches are the oldest softball team in the country. And every time they're out there, practice, game, or otherwise, they're thankful they get to be out on the diamond playing the game they love.
On the diamond,
let's go.
Experience can be quite the advantage. For this women's team, there's no shortage of that.
It's the oldest team in the country.
This is the Colorado Peaches softball team.
I, like a lot of the Peaches, just love the game and want to keep playing.
They're all over 50.
I'm Fran Simon, I'm 52, just a baby peach.
I pitch and I'm 57.
Some are well over 50.
I'm 75.
I'm 82.
I'm 90, going on 91.
That last one's Maggie.
I think I left my glove over here.
The oldest of the Peaches.
You should be my manager.
Maggie's my idol. I want to be like her when I grow up.
She's been on the team now for 12 years with no sign of slowing down.
Boxing is what keeps me in shape.
And she's serious about that.
Give him a good punch.
but clearly not the most serious of the bunch.
Joy, pitcher!
When we're not having fun, it's not working.
Even though their game isn't always perfect, it's always positive.
Way to go! I look good!
Very.
Way to turn it, ladies.
Positive.
And then she is a superstar woman.
Some friends came out here and saw us. They said, I can't believe this. It's fabulous. It's really fun.
At their age, you could say they've been around the bases a few times.
We've had knee replacements and hip replacements, and my back went out a couple of months ago.
Two knee replacements, shoulder replacement, surgery.
But still, they're out here.
Okay, speed here.
We caught up with the Peaches ahead of the World Senior Games, a big tournament out in Utah.
How many out?
Hoping to repeat or top their success from 2019.
We won the silver.
The same color as some of their hair.
Going home!
A big achievement given what was happening
out of there
off the diamond.
She was having surgery for her cancer.
The team's coach, Gail, who, like these ladies, wouldn't let illness or age get in her way.
She was in her hospital bed. And she was coaching us.
On FaceTime, I was holding my phone so she could coach, and she gave directions.
This year, though, Gail will be with the Peaches on their sleeves.
Our coach passed away in March. Just an amazing woman.
This will be the first big tournament for the team without her.
I miss her as a friend. We actually built this together.
She was wonderful. Wish she was still around.
Watch three!
This year, Fran Simon is coaching in Gail's honor.
We win just by being out here.
Slugging seniors and ground out getting grandmas with high hopes.
We're taking it all this year. We're going for the gold.
Because if experience teaches us anything,
our goal is to just have fun and to support one another.
The score of their games, just like age,
don't get hurt,
is just a number.
Even if we don't win, we win.
Colorado Peaches is our name.
The big thing is to be a worthy opponent.
Thanks so much for watching this Denver 7 Plus special presentation. I'm Jason Grenauer. From all of us at Denver 7, we hope you and your family have a happy and safe holiday season.